Okay, so hello everyone. Let me just adjust the microphone a bit. Okay, so hello everyone. My name is Mattia Manzati, and you can maybe remember me from last year's talk. And as you can see, I really care about stack safety, and I really care about recursive functions. And well, I want to start by saying that a few years ago, like 4.5 years ago, I started a journey with Effect. And it was not a great news for Giulio, unfortunately. But yeah, 4 years ago, I started a journey with Effect that gave me a lot of new hope in what I was building, a lot of new enthusiasm about my code. And today, to me, is like the end of that path and the beginning of a new path, because today I'm going to announce that I am now a new founding engineer, that I will work full-time here at Effectful. And so today's talk is mostly going to be sharing with you what I'll be working on in next month, which is basically dev tools that will allow you as Effect developers to enhance your productivity. In today's talk, we're going to discuss what's already available, which you may not be aware of unless someone has did some spoilers, and what we'll be working on soon. So when I think about the process involved in building Effect applications, I see a lot of areas that can be improved. So it may seem obvious at first, but the first area we need to improve is actually the coding phase. So when you start coding your Effect application, it's fully type safe, you feel confident, everything works, and this is great, right? Well, it's great except for those times you start battling against the type system. And sure, the type safety is great, but it comes at the cost of producing correct types. So what happens if you don't do that? Well, we know what happens, you know? And our general reaction usually is, what the fuck is happening right there? So, and if you understood why that error was caused, well, either you are a great developer or you had like terrible times. So, well, so, and mostly the second one, yeah. So, you may not know about this, but even at this phase, we already have something that can significantly improve your coding experience with Effect. And one line of code that you can introduce today in your project and will definitely make a huge difference. I'm talking about our Effect Language Service plugin. So what is it? Basically, a language service is like a protocol that TypeScript uses. Language service protocol is a protocol that is used by the editor to talk with the language service, which is understand your code semantics, in order to get information like types, auto-completion, enable tasks as refactorings, and whatever. And so the language service protocol is a standard that is supported by many editors, so not just VS Code. We had a spoiler yesterday from MySQL using it in another editor. But well, how does that influence us as Effect developers? Well, our plugin provides additional diagnostics and refactor that are specifically tailored for Effect code. So let's take a real world example. So we have like this beautiful error, and many of you know how painful it is. So you definitely cannot spot where the error is. I only see like thousands of TypeScript gibberish and things I usually don't care about. So let's try to enable the language service plugin. So it's really easy. You just install it via npm, and then you edit your tsconfig.json to add it and say, okay, we want to use the Effect language service. And then an additional task you have to do is basically to ensure that you are using the TypeScript version that comes from your node modules. Once you do that, you can immediately see that it's enabled, and the difference, in my opinion, is huge. Woo! Now you can see immediately where is the difference. Okay? So now we can see immediately that the problem is the fact that I missed one character, I missed a star, I typed yield instead of yield star, and instead of that huge TypeScript gibberish, now I get something that's meaningful for effect. And another common issue we have is like these kind of errors, we usually don't fully understand what they come from. And if we do the same with the language service plugin, we can see that the error is coming because we are missing one type of error from the expected list. So what before was like a few hundreds of line of squiggly nonsense, now you can immediately see if you have plugins like error code lenses that are used there, you can immediately see which is the exact problem you have. And another functionality is that is provided by the LSP is due to the type truncation that TypeScript does. You know, you can disable truncation globally in your project, but I don't recommend that because usually that means that even your output in building, if you have some error, will like be more slow because it has more characters to output. But you can use the LSP to get specific information about just the effect that has been truncated and get the exact non-truncated errors that are defined by your effect. So I can probably imagine that that puts a huge relief in your everyday experience in building and using effect code. But it's not just diagnostics. We also offer effect functionalities like refactors that allows, for example, given an async function to automatically rewrite that async function as an effect object. And all the promises will automatically. Thank you. And here, for example, you can see that all the promises have been wrapped in an effect. And we have like automatically built an object that defines the error. And you can choose whatever you want to have that error or not. Language service is great, but unfortunately, the language service plugin is loaded only by the editor. That means that if you have errors like this one, that is basically a floating effect. So it's an effect that it's not assigned to a variable or yielded. So basically will never be run because it's not yielded. These kind of errors will appear only if you open the editor. And that's not a great experience. You know, you maybe want something else to happen, something like triggering a red alarm in your company and opening everything in the Windows and play a horn and whatever, you know. So that's why we also plan to release a set of ESLint plugin rules that will specifically address these kind of scenarios. Well, basically, you have something that you want to mark as blocking, so we can like stop the compilation in the linting phase and we can catch these kind of mistakes that happens, and they usually they are not marked by TypeScript. And long term, we also plan to add in there more rules like stylistics one. For example, we mentioned yesterday at the workshop that one rule could be something like that for every tag you define, you may want like the string value to start with the package name, for example. That may be something that could be useful. And we will also plan to support other tooling, not only ESLint. ESLint will be the first, but we also plan to support other linting tools as well. And I strongly personally believe that building an interactive experience inside your editor thanks to the language service and the linting rules will be a significant improvement for learning effect or enhancing your effect code basis. We can use those tools to try to teach you which are the effect best practices. Take, for example, generic services, you know. Anyone, I think, has tried in his life to define a generic service. So a service that takes a type parameter, you know. It's something that you may want to define, but later on, maybe you figure out that's not so easy to do. And imagine having something like a linting rule that tells you, okay, this is not generally supported. Instead, you should create a factory service. So instead of spending time trying to make something work that is not the best solution, thanks to the linting rules, we will be able to teach the best practice of effect inside your, of your editors. And even though the language service rendering rules are great, they are not the only thing that we plan for the Effective Tools experience. You may already know that there is already a published VS Code extension that provides metrics and information about the current effect context directly inside of your VS Code editor. Setting it up is really, really easy. You just need to add it from the VS Code marketplace. And then in your code, you need to install the effect experimental package. And once you have installed that package, you have to add few lines of code around your main program in order to enable the instrumentation for the DevTools. And once you have done that, then you can try to run your application, and you'll see that in the client's panel, your effect application will automatically connect, and then you can see immediately metrics and tracer, thanks to the amazing work that team did on this experience. And this is out today. This is great, but we plan to improve this experience even more. We know that debugging effect is kind of different from any regular JS code out there. Instead of writing code that is executed as is, effect is lazy, as we know, and is just a description that is then interpreted by a runtime. And that means that if you place a debug break in any function and you look at the call stack, you get mostly some gibberish that it's about the effect runtime and you don't care about. And I mean, this is a problem that's not only strictly related to effect. Even React has the same problem, you know? So that is why we plan to allow to see your effect spans directly inside your editor when you are debugging your application. So just like we already provide for the great experience that has been built by Maxwell in the Effect Playground, we plan to enable that feature also inside your editor. But we plan to make it even more interactive by adding, for example, the ability of clicking over a span or an error that has been raised and directly go to the line of code that caused that error or that span to happen. All of these without leaving your editor. And speaking of editor, we also plan to make the DevTools agnostic of the editor you are using. So just like the React DevTools I mentioned before, we plan to build an experience that can be run basically in the browser as Chrome extension or inside VS Code or as a standalone desktop application. And in order to reach this approach, one other thing we will put effort into is also remove the requirement of wrapping your main effect program with additional code. We will make it so, just like, again, the React DevTools, we will be able to automatically connect to any JS engine that is running an effect application and start to get immediately information about the effect running. And still related to traces, this is an awesome screen that Johannes sent to me. You can recognize that was sent by Johannes, thanks by the red arrow. But yeah, basically this shows up how we also played around with some APIs that are strictly Chrome only that allow to change the name of the function in the call stack. You can see on the right that instead of seeing the gibberish fiber runtime.js, now what you can see is instead the name of the spans up until that function. Unfortunately, we cannot provide the correct line of code because you know that API is not great, but I think that this is definitely an improvement over everyday work you can do. And well, unfortunately, we are almost running out of time. There is not much to say, but everyone today spoke about the observability provided by effects. Even today, the behavior is beautiful. You can take any effect application and automatically get observability out of that. And that is, in my opinion, something that is not possible in any other library or any other language unless you use something like auto-instrumentation, which doesn't always work well. And well, so with that, I think that I'm running up of time, but I will say what's coming next for the DevTools. Well, we can shape it together. So I encourage you to come to me later and speak together, whatever are your major pain points, what you would like to see from the DevTools, the kind of errors that you spent so much time trying to understand what was really happening, and in the end, just like before, was maybe just one character missing. So we can definitely work together to improve the overall effect development experience. So again, thank you everyone for your time.